Hello. Among the commonest voice problems are those caused by vibration injury to the surface tissue caused by vocal overuse. So to understand vocal overuse and vibration injuries better, let's first talk about how vocal folds vibrate, how excessive vibration can inadvertently injure them, and what we do to help injured vocal folds heal in order to restore the voice, if possible, to normal. First, about vibration. Vibration of the vocal folds is quite a bit like that of a trumpet player's lips. To play the trumpet, you buzz these lips like that into a trumpet, and then out of the other end of the trumpet comes a trumpet sound. For voice making, you buzz the laryngeal lips or vocal folds located here in the middle of the larynx. You buzz that pair of lips, I'm showing just one here, into the vocal tract, and when the sound comes out through the lips here, then you have human voice. As I'm talking to you now, my vocal folds are vibrating perhaps 125 times for every second of sound. In a day of talking, I can therefore easily accumulate more than 1 million vibrations of my vocal folds, and each of them puts a small degree of normal and expected stress on the surface tissue of the vocal folds. Normally, the vocal folds are resilient enough to sustain that stress without becoming injured. Yet, vocal folds are a tissue, and therefore they have their limit. And if they